what we have attempted to do here is to present to you a method that is based on skeletal geometry and muscular anatomy. And everything we do derives from that. So what we're going to try to do is get past the point where we have opinions about these things and get to the point where we understand exactly how this anatomy works and how it best functions weighted. Because the weighted expression of human anatomy is barbell training. When we leave here this weekend, we want to understand things, not believe them. Okay? These things should not be in a matter of my opinion any more than they're a matter of your opinion. And if we have not accomplished that, then we wasted everybody's time and money. And I hope that we get this done, because it is will be the most valuable aspect of this, is being able to answer questions based on geometry and factual analysis. Why is strong so important? Because strong demonstrated is what you see when technique is correct. Correct technique is the most efficient display of strength. And if strength is gone, it doesn't matter how good your technique is. The squat is when you put the bar on your back or your front and squat down below parallel and come back up. Above parallel is not a squat. Take that out of your vocabulary, okay? That is a half squat or a quarter squat. But when we say the term squat, we mean the barbell exercise where the tops of your knees, the crease of your hip, go to a position that breaks the plane of parallel. All right? And it is dependent on the skeletal anatomy. We've basically got three different segments here that we're dealing with. We're dealing with the leg, the thigh, and the back. And as a result, three angles are established here that we use for diagnosis in this process. The first is the knee angle. This is the angle formed by the tibia and the femur. The second is the hip angle. And the hip angle is the angle that is formed by the rigid back operating as a rigid unit and the femur. And third is the angle that we call the back angle that is formed between the floor, the horizontal reference, and the back. And these three angles are terribly critical, because we will look at people, and when you look at people squat, what you're looking at are these angles. You've got to learn to recognize them and use them as part of your analysis of their lifting.